This is Dave Simon. I wanted to talk today about this dual customer relationship that we all have in our music schools. We really have two customers. We don't have one. We have the parent and we've got the child. And the parent and the child are looking for completely different things in their interaction with us. A parent is looking for the growth and the benefit that music lessons will bring to their child. The kid is only interested in the experience. The kid's criteria is fun. Will they have fun? Will they enjoy music? Will they maybe meet other kids? And the parent, it's completely different, and it's important in our messaging that we take that into consideration. And really what made me think of this is today I saw a music school, it's actually a music school franchise, and they, in their message, it was, we will teach you to be a musician. Okay, simple, it's pretty clear what they, you know, what their claim is, what their promise is, but the person who's going to see that message are parents. Not kids. Kids, you know, might see that when they come into the building, or maybe, you know, maybe their social media efforts are targeting kids. But mom's the one who writes the check, so you know, you would think that their message would or should target the parent. Or really, all of our messaging should be geared to the parent up until a certain point. So Danny Thompson of the Music Factory, he's got this tagline: "Music band classes and music lessons, as cool as your kid." I love that one. I actually use it. I've seen a lot of schools say things like "music lessons your kids will love," "music lessons your kids will thank you for." It's all about the customer. It's not about the product. It's an antiquated model to be product focused. It, you know, nowadays everything's about the customer. How will the customer's life benefit from it, from your service? So when you say, you know, that we will turn your kid into or we make musicians. Yeah, that's the tagline. When you say we make musicians, you're talking about you. You're talking about the product. You're not talking about the customer. And then this whole idea of saying, hey, we're going to turn your kid into a musician. Now, some of you might have heard my survey or my interviews with parents trying to get a sense of what it is that they look for out of music lessons. They are not looking for their kids to be musicians. They are only interested in their child benefiting from music lessons, becoming more confident, finding something that they love and that they're passionate about, being able to use music as a way to connect with other people throughout life. They're not focused on the quality of their child's experience. They're, in terms of what they're going to learn, they're concerned about, well, the quality of the experience in terms of how it's going to benefit the child's overall well-being. Now, a child, the kid, your student, they're the one who's going to, that message of we're going to make you a musician, that's something that's going to resonate with them. And that kind of goes back to the whole duality of this, you know, relationship we have with our customers. There's one message for the parent: your child is going to benefit from coming here. They'll be a happier person. And the message to the kid is, your student, is this is going to be a fun experience. So in my studio, the messaging shifts once the kid's into the school, and actually the messaging is solely targeted at the kid at that point. I want to share with you this school out of Los Rios, California, called Los Rios Rock School. They have a really great, or they're really big into offering tours for prospective students and really making that tour a real special and unique moment for kids. And they had said on their Teacher Zone podcast that when they give a student and a family a tour, all of the their focus and energy is to the kid. They don't talk to the parent. I mean, maybe you know, I'm it's only natural to address the parent occasionally, but it's all about empowering the child, treating the child as the decision maker. We know, I mean, look, the kid's a big part of the decision, but ultimately the parents have to be on board with it as well. They'll be on board with it when they see how their child feels empowered, how the message has shifted to them, and maybe the child at that point has never had an experience like that, where an adult is addressing them and treating them like a maybe more mature person than what they're used to. So, you know, we can look at that Los Rios model and say, hey, you know, we can take what they do and continue that on throughout the lifetime of the customer at our studio, where we're focused on the student messaging to them. We know the parent is going to be hearing that message, but they're going to have either a positive or negative response to it, but focusing the message on the front end to the parent. So this will forever be a complication or the complexity we have in our businesses with really having two students, the parent and the child. There aren't many businesses like that. If you look at, you know, let's say a gym, a person enrolls in a gym, the person enrolling and who's going to use that membership is usually the same person. But we really have to be savvy salespeople and business people as we're navigating through this dual relationship of parent and child.